So the best way to find out about anything is to Google it. So I typed in Python keyword from. Here I scanned all of the results that were available. And then from there, I landed on this webpage. By the way, the link to this website is also available in the instructor notes. Now, this webpage says that Python's from statement lets you import specific attributes from a module. So I guess it allows you to say from module or file name, import something. So I guess our code then means that from something called Twilio.rest, we want to import Twilio REST client. Now, this got me curious about what these things called Twilio.rest and Twilio REST client were. So then I went back to Google and tried to find out how Twilio was actually implemented. So I typed in Twilio Python code. Then I looked through these results and I got to this website called GitHub. Here, I could read all of the code that actually makes Twilio work behind the scenes. By the way, this link is also available in the instructor notes. Now in the code for Twilio, I found that there was this folder called Twilio, so I clicked on it. Now inside that folder is another folder called REST. And within REST, there is a Python file, which if we look through, we will find that there is a class called Twilio REST Client inside it. So when we write this line of code, from Twilio.rest import Twilio REST Client, what we are telling the computer is, hey, inside Twilio, there is a folder called REST. And inside that folder is a class called Twilio REST Client. And we are going to use that class inside our code. And if we go back and look in our code, here is how we are using that class Twilio REST Client. Now, you know, if we were writing this code from scratch, we probably wouldn't have written this line of code. We would have modified it to say, from Twilio, import REST. Now with this line of code, what we are telling the computer is, hey, inside the folder Twilio is another folder called REST. Import that because we are going to use that in our program. And we know that inside the folder REST is the class Twilio REST Client. So I would now access that class by saying REST.TwilioRestClient. Let me save and run this program one more time to see if it still works. All right, here's my phone, and let's see if I get a text message anytime soon. Aha, there's the text message. It seems like our program still works. So in the next video, what I want to do is revisit the idea of how Twilio, REST, and Twilio REST Client are related with one another.